Hey, what's up, guys? So I have made a handful of videos on ashwagandha over the past several years, and a large reason for this is that it seems to be one of the more versatile herbal supplements that really exists. Now, I just got done finishing and publishing the complete guide to supplementation that outlines 9 specific health goals that men are typically interested in, and ashwagandha by far is the one supplement that shows up in most of these categories. However, one of the more interesting effects of ashwagandha is its effects on testosterone levels. However, up until this point, I have not made an in-depth video discussing the specific mechanisms of action that are related to its ability to increase testosterone. And so essentially what I want to do in this video is just take a super deep dive into the effects of ashwagandha on testosterone levels. Now, the reason I think ashwagandha is the most interesting supplement when it comes to possible compounds that could be used to improve testosterone levels is simply because it appears to affect testosterone levels because of several different mechanisms, not just one. Now, things like Tonkat Ali, the primary mechanism of action there appears to be its ability to block estrogen receptors and thereby signal to your body that you need more testosterone production. However, when it comes to ashwagandha, there appear to be 3 primary mechanisms of action that I do want to cover in this video. Now, the first one that we're going to talk about is arguably ashwagandha's primary mechanism by which it increases testosterone, and that is that it appears to significantly reduce stress markers. Now, one thing I do think it's important to point out here is that there does appear to be a difference between the effects of acute stress and chronic stress when it comes to effects on testosterone. Now, it has been repeatedly shown that acute stressors actually increase testosterone levels. Now, this does make sense if you think about testosterone in the terms of stress resilience. Testosterone does increase the body's resilience to stress, and so it makes sense that your body would actually release testosterone and produce testosterone in response to stressors. However, again, there does appear to be a significant difference between acute stress and chronic stress, and so there does appear to be a point at which these acute stressors that typically increase testosterone actually cross over and cross somewhat of a threshold and become chronic stressors and thereby then decrease levels of testosterone. Now, the reasoning behind this could probably be argued in depth. However, it does appear that the body can really only handle so much stress before it starts to pull back its resources and production of testosterone. Now, it should be noted here that ashwagandha appears to be most effective and most efficient in these specific situations of chronic stress and not acute stress. Now, ashwagandha has specifically been shown to reduce stress and increase testosterone by specifically reducing levels of cortisol. And the reason this is so effective is that cortisol production and testosterone production both share a similar precursor and substrate known as pregnenolone. Now, pregnenolone can be converted either into cortisol or testosterone. However, your body can only produce so much pregnenolone. And so when you have a high demand on cortisol production, it will restrict the production of testosterone. And so by lowering the body's demand on cortisol and reducing cortisol levels, your body does have more pregnenolone available in order to turn into testosterone. Now, the second way that ashwagandha appears to increase testosterone levels is by increasing thyroid hormone levels. Now, this one is particularly interesting because of the specific mechanism by which ashwagandha appears to increase thyroid hormone levels. Now, your body typically produces thyroid hormones when a region of the brain known as the hypothalamus detects a drop in thyroid hormone levels or an increase in the demand on thyroid hormones. And when this happens, it releases a hormone known as thyrotropin-releasing hormone, which then stimulates the pituitary gland to produce thyroid-stimulating hormone, which then subsequently stimulates the thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormone. Now, what's interesting here is that ashwagandha has actually been clinically shown to reduce levels of thyroid-stimulating hormone, which is super interesting because typically you would expect thyroid-stimulating hormone to be elevated in instances that thyroid hormones are elevated, which seems to suggest that ashwagandha is actually bypassing this step and actually directly stimulating the thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormones. Now, the reason this is so important is that when you directly stimulate the thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormones, it actually provides a negative feedback loop to the hypothalamus, hypothalamus to cease the production of thyrotropin-releasing hormone, as well as thyroid-stimulating hormone. Now, the reason this is so important is that thyrotropin-releasing hormone, as well as thyroid-stimulating hormone, both have a negative impact on the HPG axis. When these hormones are released, it actually causes an increase in prolactin levels, as well as a suppression of luteinizing hormone, which is the hormone that actually tells the testes and the lytic cells of the testes to produce testosterone. So essentially what happens when you take ashwagandha is that there's this long feedback whereby ashwagandha stimulates the thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormones, which then shuts down the production of TRH and TSH, which then increases levels of luteinizing hormone and suppresses levels of prolactin, which ultimately have a positive impact on testosterone production. Now, the third way that ashwagandha appears to increase testosterone levels is by directly stimulating the production of gonadotropic releasing hormone. Now, gonadotropic releasing hormone is the hormone that the hypothalamus releases that tells the pituitary to release luteinizing hormone, which then subsequently tells the testes to produce testosterone. Now, this process is typically initiated by low levels of DHT and estrogen, and when receptors in the hypothalamus detect low levels of these hormones, it actually triggers the hypothalamus to release gonadotropic releasing hormone, which again is going to subsequently increase levels of luteinizing hormone and testosterone production. However, it is important to note here that this is not the only mechanism by which gonadotropic releasing hormone is produced. There are also a handful of neurotransmitters that actually trigger the production of gonadotropic releasing hormone as well, namely GABA and acetylcholine, as well as a very specific serotonin receptor known as the 5-HT2A receptor. And coincidentally, ashwagandha improves the signaling of all three of these neurotransmitter systems. Now, because of all these mechanisms, again, this is one of the reasons why I consider ashwagandha to be one of the more effective supplements when it comes to increasing testosterone levels, as well as improving stress levels, improving sleep, improving cognition, as well as athletic performance. However, this is also one of the reasons why there are so many potential side effects when it comes to ashwagandha supplementation. So I will say that ashwagandha supplementation is not for everyone. However, when it comes to, again, supplements that can be used to improve testosterone, I do believe ashwagandha to be one of the more promising. Now, if you guys are interested in my full breakdown on foundational supplements, as well as supplements that can be used for testosterone, cognition, muscle growth, stress, sleep, mood, hair loss, and libido, I would highly recommend checking out the complete guide to supplementation that you can find a link to in the description. If you guys are into supplementation at all, I can guarantee you that this resource will become extremely invaluable to you. But other than that, guys, if you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys next time.